forward rate agreement. Going forward, we would simply be referring this to as FRA. It's a forward contract where underlying asset is a loan. Now, there can be two sides to this forward contract. Either it could be long or it could be short. A long will have right and obligation. As long as it's a forward, it will always be both. Short will also have right and obligation. Tell me now, right and obligation to what? Do you buy a loan? So easy memory technique is that generally long, we say it is right and obligation to buy. So in this case, it would be right and obligation to borrow. So that way you can remember it easily. Right and obligation to borrow and right and obligation to lend. Right and obligation to borrow, right and obligation to lend. Now let us say you have entered into an agreement that you have a right and obligation to borrow at 6%. You have signed the agreement. Now, will you want interest rate to increase or decrease? You want to borrow. You want to borrow. Do you want interest rate to increase or decrease?
Increase.
You want to borrow. You have signed an agreement which allows you to borrow at 6%. Do you want interest rates to increase or decrease?
Increase.
How many of you feel increase? Decrease? Okay. So, now you would want interest rates to decrease because you would get to borrow at a cheaper rate compared to what is the rate in the market. That means a long will benefit. A long will benefit if interest rate decreases. Sorry. If interest rate increases, because then he gets to borrow at a rate lesser than the rate in the market. And in the same fashion, short will benefit if interest rate decreases. And it's like any other asset. When you are long, you want rates to increase. Correct? So here also you want interest rates to increase. And here you want interest rates to decrease. Now let us do some examples. Now there is a peculiar convention attached to this FRA. You'd see a FRA like this, which says 3 into 5 FRA. So how do you read this 3 into 5? See carefully. The maturity of the forward contract, is 90 days. How did I get this 90 days? 3 into 30. But the loan that you can take is going to be for a period of, tell me, 5. It is going to be for a period of 60 days. So this second term, 5, is inclusive of the first one. So when they say 3 into 5, you're essentially thinking of this as maturity of 3 months of the forward contract and the loan going to be of 2 months. Is that fine? And that's how it is quoted as 3 by 5. So this second term includes this entire spectrum. Do you want to try one more?
Yes.
Write down this first. Let us say there is a 1 into 4 FRA. What would be maturity of forward contract? 30 days. But what would be the duration of underlying loan? 90 or 120? 90 days. Because the second term is going to be 3. It's quoted as 1 by 4. That means the maturity is going to be of 90 days. What if? It means the loan you take here. You get to take loan here on day 30. And you take it for what period? 90 days. Let us say it is quoted as 2 by 6 FRA. Then maturity of forward contract, 60. Loan would be of
120.
Are we doing okay? 3/2 FRA. Maturity, 90 days. And loan, minus 30 days. So, which is not possible, which means the second term will always be higher than the first term. Are we doing fine? So, let's do an example on this now. Let us say we've been quoted a 3/6 FRA. We signed the agreement. We have decided to take a long position. The underlying notional principal is $1 million. The reason why it's called notional, because generally you never do a delivery. You never really take a loan. You just do the cash settlement. That's why it is referred to as the notional principal. So notional principal 1 million and the rate at which we've signed the contract is 6%. So meaning of this agreement is that after 90 days, we have a right and obligation to take loan for a period of 90 days again. Do you agree? Now what happens is, after 90 days, 90 day LIBOR turns out to be 7%. After 90 days, the actual 90 day LIBOR turns out to be 7%. Now we are here. We are on this date. Please observe carefully. Do not write. We are on this date. This is where our loan starts. What is the rate at which we would be getting the loan? 6%. But what is the rate in the market? 7%. So is that a profit or loss? It is a profit because we get to borrow at a cheaper rate. What we want to learn here is how to calculate that profit, the amount at which that cash settlement is going to happen. So observe carefully. I'll give you reasonable time to write later on. Let me use this space. Step number one, we will calculate the profit in percentage. So we have a right to borrow at 7, rate in the market 6, profit is 1%. Step number 2, we will convert this to amount. So 1 million into 1%, the total profit is 10,000. Step number 3, your profit would have been 10,000 had you borrowed for one entire year. Are you borrowing for 1 year? No, this 6% and 7% is annual rate. We are borrowing only for 90 days. So in step number 3, we will have to adjust that for time period. So 10,000 into 90 divided by 360, your actual profit is going to be 2,500. And this 2,500 will definitely be one of the three options. This 2,500 will definitely be one of the three options on the exam, and this is going to be a wrong answer because there is a step number 4. And now please understand this carefully. Let us say you people agree that you would give me 100,000 worth of loan at the rate of 6%, or let us say at the rate of 7%. So I will take this money from you and I will go to a bank and I will deposit that money, let us say at the rate of 8%. I'm just making it up. Now what will happen is, this is time 0. This is year 1. After 1 year from now, to you people, how much will I have to pay? 7,000. But how much bank will give me? 8,000. So how much is profit? 1,000. Is that profit coming to you at time 0 or time 1? It is coming to you at time 1. If I want to know how much profit I have made at time 0 by being able to procure a loan from you at a cheaper price, I will have to take a present value of this 1,000 for 1 year. Exactly in the same fashion, this profit of 2500 is going to come to us here. This profit of 2500 is going to be 90 days from the date of settlement, but we want to know what is the settlement amount on this date, the date at which you take the loan. So this 2500 we will have to discount backwards. But since we are discounting using LIBOR, the rule of thumb that we are going to follow is that LIBOR never compounds. So how will we do this? We will say future value 2500, n has to be 1. There is no, we cannot change this. But what is the current rate in the market? 7%. But can we say 7% is the IY? No, because we are just borrowing for 90 days. So you would say IY is equal to 1.75%. How did I get this? 7 into 90 divided by 360. Do you agree? And then we will say compute present value 2457, which would be your final answer. And if you do not want to extend it so much, you can also use a formula, which would be 2500 divided by 1 plus 1.75%, same values. There is a large formula given in the curriculum and in the notes. If you understand these four steps, you can avoid need to remember the formula. But it's essential you understand what steps we have followed. Okay, let's do one more. Let us say it is a 1/7 FRA. We have entered into the short side. Notional amount is $10 million. And the rate is 8%. Now, after 30 days, after 30 days, 210-day LIBOR is 7.5%. After 30 days, 180-day LIBOR is 7%. After 180 days, 30-day LIBOR is 6%. Calculate payoff to the short on the contract maturity. Do you want to try? To the short on contract maturity. Alright, let's do it together. 1 into 7 FRA would mean that the maturity of the contract is 30 days and the maturity of the loan is 180 days. So this rate for us was irrelevant. This rate was also irrelevant. The relevant rate for us was 7%. So on this date, for us the applicable rate is 8%, whereas the rate in the market is 7%. So now we will do those steps. Step number one, we have a right to give loan lent at what rate? 8%. Rate in the market? 7%. Benefit or loss? Benefit. Benefit of 1%. Step number two, this benefit needs to be converted to amount. So 10 million into 1% would be 100,000. So 10 million into 1% is 100,000. Step number three, we will have to adjust this for time period. So 100,000 into, we are taking loan for how many days? 180 days. So 180 divided by 360, the profit is going to be 50,000. But this 50,000 profit will happen to us on 180 days from now. What we have to do is take a present value of this. So step number 4, future value 50,000, n is always 1, IY, the interest or yield would be, what is the rate in the market right now? 7, but that needs to be adjusted. So that would be 3.5%, and then we will compute present value. So your answer is 48309. Any step you want me to repeat? Have you understood this? Thank you.